Hello everyone. So today we'll be touching upon the remaining theories of selective attention. The first theory is the filter attenuation theory, which was developed by Tresemann in the year 1962. So basically, attenuation means how the strength, the value, the effect, can be reduced of a stimuli, So this particular theory proposed that, the stimuli, which actually were not getting the access, through the selective filter at a given moment of time, that was actually proposed by Broadbent, as per this theory, they will not be completely blocked. So the stimuli that were actually, literally ignored, and the ones that were left out, as per this theory, which is the filter attenuation theory, they will not be completely blocked. Instead, they will be processed weakly. That means that their strength will get reduced because of the attenuator. Their strength will be reduced, and some of them might manage to actually pass through the selective filter. So this theory actually says that the filter is going to attenuate, which means it's going to weaken, the strength of the stimuli. So some of the stimuli out of the many will actually be able to also escape, or rather pass through the selective filter, and they will be able to reach the higher levels of processing. So many a times we've noticed that when we have like really huge gatherings, over there, in the middle of many conversations or rather discussions, people tend to call out our names, they call out our names very softly, but still, we can hear that somebody's actually calling me out, and we immediately turn towards them, even if it's in the middle of loud conversations, really elaborative discussions, we still pay attention to our name being called out, even if the name has been called out, in a very soft tone, at a very low level of sound. So such stimuli, are actually, even though very, very weak, they have actually been able to generate responses occasionally, because they've actually managed to literally, slip or pass or escape the selective filter. So this is what the Tresemann's attention model is talking about, that the stimuli will not get blocked completely. The remaining stimuli, they will not be blocked completely. Rather, their strength will be weakened, and some of them can manage to pass through the selective filters and will be able to generate the responses. Now, of course, we have the next very, very interesting model. That's again, a theory that we're going to be discussing about, and that is the multimode theory. And this theory was developed by Johnston and Haynes, and it was developed in the year 1978. Very interesting theory, which says that attention is a very flexible system, and that it does allow the selection of stimuli over the others, which means over the other stimuli, at three stages. So that's being done at three stages. Let us really understand what are these three stages. When we talk about stage one, it's all about sensory representations, or so to say about the visual images, and all the visual images of stimuli are constructed in stage one. When we talk about stage two, it's talking mainly about the names, which means that it's talking about the semantic representations. It's talking about the names of the objects. They are getting constructed in stage two. When we talk about stage three, the sensory representations and of course the semantic representations are actually entering the consciousness. Now, what is this consciousness? It is the state of awareness. When a person gets aware or becomes aware of his own perceptions, he becomes responsive, or he becomes aware of his surroundings. So my state of awareness is my state of consciousness. I'm conscious about it. You know, I'm conscious of my surroundings or whatever has been happening around me. You know, so that state of awareness is called my consciousness, and that is my stage three. Now, finally, the sensory representations and, of course, the semantic representations have been able to enter the consciousness. Now, of course, you know, when we talk about processing, when the processing of information is going to get more elaborative, definitely it will require more and more of mental effort, being like literally getting into it. So more mental effort one has to literally put into processing of information. The more intense it becomes, the more mental effort it requires. When we talk about when we talk about the messages that are getting selected, you know, on the basis of, let's say, stage one. So that the processing, of course, is going to require less mental effort if we compare it with stage three, because it's in stage three, the processing of information will become intense. It will become more complex, and probably it will become more than what was happening in stage one. So, of course, over there in stage three, more of mental effort will be required then, you know. So this is what it's trying to make us understand, that how the stimuli, you know, are being selected, you know, on the basis of these various, stages, you know, how are they being selected? So we have the stage one, two, and of course the stage three, and how, when the processing of information, as and how it becomes more complex, it will require more and more of mental effort. So this was all about the theories of selective attention. Thank you so much.